next dimension in God will require the saints of God to access the knowledge and the giftings of God that are available to every saint of God that's washed in His blood and baptized in His precious Holy Spirit. Apostle Paul would say it this way, "My brethren, I would not have you ignorant concerning spiritual gifts. There are those that perpetrate in the body of Christ." I don't want to be heavy. I know it's just Bible study night. But there are those that perpetrate in the body of Christ a facade of God. And when you get near them, you feel nothing of His presence. In fact, the very presence of the Lord, His glory, the word for glory, one of the Hebrew words for glory is doxa. It is a weighty, heavy, weighty substance. And we have churches today and saints today who carry no weight. We have people, preachers, rather, in the pulpits who have no measure of greatness about them. Sure, we can shout. We can spit, we can scream, we can cup our hand. But is there any substance to what we're saying? I'm convinced that the Lord is calling for a church today who has substance behind their I'm convinced that there's a call for us today to have substance behind our shout. I'm not just shouting because it's the thing to do when I get to church. I'm not just shouting because it's programmed behavior. Many in the church today, if we miss a service where the Hammond's not pumping and the shout is not going, we think we have missed the glory, or the preacher missed his presence. Something was wrong somewhere, but maybe sometimes God wants to speak to us in a still, small voice. Because the bottom line at the end of the message and at the end of the shout, at the end of the praise, at the end of the hallelujah, at the end of turn around three times and high five your neighbor, is there any substance? Is there any weight? Is there any doxa? Is there any glory on your amen? Oh, hallelujah. I'm convinced that they that have spent time in prayer and studied to show themselves approved, a workman that needeth not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, as Paul instructs his son in the Lord, Timothy, I believe it's those of us who have spent time on our knees, and more than studying man's theory, we've been studying God's face. We have kept His presence before us. And those of us who have kept the presence of God before us, it is those of us who have weight behind our praise. At the end of the day, is there substance behind my praise? At the end of the day, is there substance behind my shout? Is there presence on my praise? Otherwise, what we do when we come to the house of God is merely entertainment. Musicians are entertaining us. Psalmists are merely singing to us. And we can get that kind of entertainment at home on the television. Gun smoke carries more glory than Shekinah. Because saints today, are missing something. I don't think it's so for this house. And I don't think it's so for those of us who are seeking the face of God. And we want to be so full of His glory and full of His measure of greatness. I've often said that greatness always seeks for greatness. And there is something inside of me that longs for something more than church as usual. There's something inside of me that longs for more than just to be entertained when I come to church. There's something inside of me that longs for something more than to rub shoulders with business partners. There's something more inside of me that longs for something more than a good dance and a good shout and a good sweat. I want to be able to touch the heart of God. And then when I've touched his heart, I want to feel his embrace. I want to feel his presence. I want to feel his power. I want to be empowered. If when we leave this service tonight, you're not empowered, then I've not done my job. If when you leave service on Sunday morning, the saints of God are not empowered, then the minister has not done his job. If when you sing the praises of God and you play upon the instruments, the saints of God are not empowered, then we've not done our job. Oh, we may have gotten paid to play. We may have gotten paid to sing. It may have been a position for us, but is there presence? Oh, somebody shout presence. If you want his power, shout presence. If you want to see his glory, shout presence. And so I believe that we're in a moment and in a time where we have to repent of low-level thinking. We have to come to a place in ministry and in life. Wave your hand at me, leaders, because I want to talk to some leaders. We have to be at a place tonight where we repent of low-level thinking. It is the low-level thinking that will keep us from accessing the high place and the high thought of God. Peter would say, be established in present truth. And so if there's present truth, undoubtedly there's truth that was for yesterday. If there's present truth and present glory, then undoubtedly there's something that was yesterday's truth and yesterday's glory. And I, beloved, do not want to go back to a yesterday's glory. I don't want to experience yesterday's power. I wish I had somebody to help me. I don't want to experience yesterday's healing. I don't want to experience yesterday's tent meeting. I want a fresh touch of the Holy Ghost. I need to sense his power now. Not only for me, but for my children. Oh, hallelujah. So I have to find myself today in a place of repentance. Repentance is not just for the sinner. Touch your neighbor and say, it's not just for the sinner. You have to take up your cross and follow him daily. Sanctification is not for a new babe in Christ. It's a daily process that you and I are to be walking out in the Spirit. Sanctify me, God. Hallelujah. Lift your hands now and ask God to touch you with his presence. Matthew chapter 3 and verse 2, you see John the Baptist, one crying from the wilderness, prepare ye the way of the Lord. And he would say these words, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. And in Matthew chapter 4 and verse 17, you see Jesus coming on the scene saying, repent, for the kingdom of God is at hand. This word repentance in the original Greek is the word metaneo. It means to change one's mind, change one's direction. I broke it down this afternoon in study in the room, and it has two parts to it. It's the word meta and neo. Meta means with, and neo means understanding. So true repentance comes when we have understanding. Whew. Let me help somebody. When the Holy Ghost came on you and you had understanding of what the finished work of Jesus was about, his death, burial, and resurrection, you had that understanding. You realized that you were a sinner in need of a Savior. You were lost and undone on your way to hell. But thanks be unto God that understanding, that I believed with my heart and I confessed with my that he is Lord to the glory of God the Father. I had an understanding come to me and my spirit was saved. But man is not just a spirit.